Russell set to drop the puck. Here we go. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro set to bring you all this Hockey Ultimate Team matchup. The officials there at center, and I think we are about to get this one underway. Great night for hockey, and period number one is underway. Makes a move, and the puck hops away from him. There's the whistle. Let's see what the referee saw.
Didn't take long for the coach to start shaking his head. A penalty on the first shift of the game.
Here's a change.
Stamkos is out here on the power play, and it's an opportunity for him to use his zone ability to hopefully deliver a good scoring chance. I'm going to be watching for that, guys.
The 67s win it in the defensive zone. Grabs the puck here in their own end. Moves it quickly over to Rattray. Centering pass, and that's intercepted. Puck slid down the ice. Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end.
Well, this power play hasn't gone according to plan. They don't have a shot on net, and now they're back in their zone, regrouping again.
The 67s gain possession along the wall. Montreal's got the puck in their own end. The Canadiens gain the zone. On the backhand, and they score! On the power play, they make it happen.
Really tough for the goalie to read where the heck this thing's going. I'm looking at the shot. I can't tell where it's going, but the backhander beats the goaltender.
Montreal's got a 1-0 lead, and they've got their crowd on their feet here.
Early on, the entertainment is here. Early lead for the home team, the first goal in the first 5 minutes, and now you push for another.
Puck picked up by Dali. There's the whistle. We've got an offside. Still plenty of time left in this frame. 1-0 is where we sit at this point. Face-off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Montreal's got the puck along the wall. Puts it on net. Oh, aggressive move as he pokes it away. The 67s take it across the blue line. Can't get a hold of that pass. Maintains possession. Here he is from the slot. Oh, what a save by Bobrovsky.
It's a really good save. In tight, he shuts down the area where the puck can go by getting out onto the puck. And there's nowhere for the shooter to put it.
Big time stop.
Dead center, excellent save.
The 67s have it in the offensive end. Taken by Hanifin. Montreal's got possession here in the neutral zone. The 67s gain control of the puck against the wall. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Poked away at center by Duchesne. Fires it! Pass! It's in! He scores! I think he knocked it in!
Yeah, he did. He's fishing around trying to find it, and he ends up pushing it back into his own net.
We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. We are all tied up in this one. Puck is dropped and play resumes. Montreal's got possession at center. All alone! Oh, denies him with the save! I think he got the blocker on it!
Sometimes you're in close, there's no room to put it anywhere. The goalie smothered it all.
From point blank! Oh, the blocker was right there to come up big by Bobrovsky. Gets it to the other point. Backhander! Oh, what a stop by Bobrovsky! Tremendous pressure here in the offensive end! Skates with it. Moves it to the corner. Waiting! Off the post! What an unlucky pass for them right there! Carries it! And a whistle stops the play. We've got a penalty coming up on the defenders here.
More and more commonplace around the league is this 1-3-1 set. We saw it earlier in the game, and you start to create mismatches all over the ice with the players moving and creating shots.
From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Kempe's got it against the boards. The 67s get a hold of the puck undermanned. Puck bounces into the bench and we'll get a face-off. Kaliev's ready for the draw as they continue to be shorthanded here. The 67s get a hold of the puck in their own end. Here's the pass in front! And we're going to get a penalty coming up here. As we get set for the faceoff, a chance to see both teams in a little four-on-four action here.
Puck control is critical on a four-on-four as the game is right now. Faceoff holds greater importance to me when you're down a man on each side.
Here's a chance! Oh, and another beauty stop right there! Grabs the puck in the corner. Montreal's working the puck near the point. Directs it on over to Toffoli. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. Montreal's got control of it now from their own end. Here's a shot! Oh, that goes off the mask. He keeps it out using his head on that play.
What do you think hurts more? He's got a headache or his jaw's sore? That thing was a bullet.
Effective use of the paddle on that one. On the backhand! Stones him in front. Takes the feed. Just applying the squeeze here in the offensive end. The fans are all over it. Oh, what a save by the goaltender! Big time collision there! Oh, what a collision! And they'll skate it out of the zone. Quick pass to Hanifin. Backhander in front! Scores! And there's the go-ahead goal as they capitalize on the power play.
Game, you want your special team to maybe get an opportunity, and then they've got to take advantage. This game's untied because that power play was ready to go to work.
Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. The 67s are hanging on to this one goal lead. They'd love to add another. Moves it to Larkin. He's got a step! Scores! What a finish!
Yeah, once he gets into the clear, it's like he's so decisive on what he wants. And he puts it away for the goal.
The 67s have given themselves a two-goal lead, but why does everybody consider this the most dreaded lead in hockey?
I think because teams tend to get a little bit tentative. They're comfortable with the two-goal lead. Don't give up the aggression now. There's too much hockey left to be played.
Martinez has it in the defensive end. Here's a short pass to Breakaway. Nothing doing.
That plan didn't work.
They go on the attack from the left side. Here's a great use of the stick right there to poke it away. The 67s move the puck in the defensive zone. Here we go, odd man rush here. Quick feed to Pasternak. And that's out of reach and out of the offensive zone. Feeds the puck to Martinez. Now a quick pass to Larkin. Montreal's got a hold of it along the wall. Moves it quickly over to Retray. Picked up along the wall by Dahlin. Nearing the final 60 seconds here this first period. Cuts to the paint. Scores! And puts it in!
I love this release, James. I mean, the shooters are getting rid of the puck quicker and quicker. She's got that puck on her stick for a millisecond. Now she's got her arms in the air with a goal.
Late goings of this period. The Canadians have answered back in these last few minutes, but still need one more to even the score. The 67s get a hold of the puck off the draw. Steps into the offensive end. The Canadians are in transition. And he takes the feed. There's the horn to conclude period number one, and Ray Ferraro's already off to grab his intermission hot dog. We'll be back in just a moment. crowd set to drop the puck here on period number two. The second stanza is underway as the puck is dropped. Let's go. Ray, you're between the benches. How did you see things after that first period?
Montreal's probably pretty happy with that first period that they played. They had the puck a lot, but what they have to change is they trail by one.
He was totally locked in on that play. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. It's a one-goal hockey game. 3-2 is where we sit. The 67s take possession off the faceoff. The Canadians go to work on offense. Long jam in front, that's broken up. Poked away in the neutral zone by Dahlin. Laying the body. Moves around along the half wall. Denies up with the blocker. What a stop by Ranta.
That's in a dangerous spot. He makes a good save here.
Officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another faceoff here. The 67s will go to work here in the offensive zone. All alone! Quick stop by Bobrovsky. Oh, and that's poked away in the offensive zone by Coleman. Here's a shot, and he uses the glove to keep that out, getting a piece of it. Bobrovsky's on top of the puck, and that'll stop the play.
Pretty conservative play here, James, as he covers it up to kill the play.
Poulin's won the draw, and her squad will go to work. And now it's over to Stone. Montreal's got the puck. Retray's got it across the line. Pass back to the point. Cuts to the front. Nice pass. Montreal's got a hold of it against the wall. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. The 67s take possession in the defensive end. Puck grabbed by Nurse. Montreal's got it in their own zone. And a little body contact on that play. The 67s scoop it up along the boards.
Really good play to score and to get this game back to even. Now we'll see who can grab momentum. When you get into this position, that puck's got to be off your stick in a hurry. You don't have much time to think about it.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Batherson's won the draw here in the open ice. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Olofsson. Duchesne's got it in the offensive zone. From one end of the blue line to the other. And he makes a save on that play. Taken along the wall by Duchesne. And now he tries to get it across to Ekblad. Olofsson's got it in the defensive end. Center and feed!
Play. Quick pass on the tape and into the net. So quickly the goalie can't get closed up and make the save.
Montreal's defense translates into some offense and they got the lead.
Well, when the game's tied, you can't start taking a bunch of unnecessary chances. They've got the lead now and we'll see if they can extend it before the break.
Batherson's won possession. And now it's grabbed by Mete. Montreal's looking to break out of their own end. Quick feed for Patterson. The 67s have it now. Oh, they couldn't connect on the play. And he regains control of the puck. Cuts into the paint. Decides to think about it. The 67s have it from their own end. Puck dumped in and the forwards are going to skate off. Along the wing up the neutral zone. They've got numbers. Swing and a miss. Slides the puck to Keliev. And he feeds it down to Smith. Montreal's going on the attack as they gain the zone. From the backhand in front. Oh, denies them with the paddle save. Quick pass to Pyro. point. Moves it to the middle. A blast! Oh, what a chance, and it goes sideways. Moves it to Coleman. And look at this. All sorts of pressure here, building. Looking, looking. Skates to the net. And they'll skate it out of the zone. And look at this. Here they come again on the attack. It's a shot. Big time save right there. Bobrovsky's going to cover up the puck here for a whistle.
He makes a safe play and kills the play before any other damage can be done.
Getting into the later stages of this period, it's a one-goal game here. 4-3 is where we sit. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Still keeps a hold of it. Here's a short pass to Larkin. Oh, what a chance here. Can they make it happen on this 2-on-1? Big time stop there. Oh, he had the right idea, but couldn't make that play with the pass. Here's a blast, and he blocks the shot. Great defensive play. Just wide of the net. The 67s have it against the wall. Periods down, a third period to go. Stick around and join us for the drama next.
Finish to this. Last shot wins.
Gains control of the puck here on the line. Quick shot. Oh, what a stop on the play. Puck scooped up by Pastrnak. Taken by Hanifin. The 67s gain possession. Oh, that sounded like a hard crash against the wall. On the attack along the boards. Sends it quickly to Coleman. Sends a pass over. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Nice zone entry on the left side. The 67s take it along the wall. Montreal's got the puck in their own end. Skates across the blue line. Can't make it work. Through center along the wing. Odd man rush.
Montreal's out front in this game, in large part by the way the second line is playing. The coach is going with a gut feel and the way it looks by getting them on the ice more than anybody else.
Can't make the connection on the pass. Takes the feed. Things start to get a little physical out there. Puck dumped in. Quick feed to Ekblad. Streaking into the attacking zone for the right. Directed over to Nurse. And that slides right out to center ice. Good hit on the play. The 67s gain control of the puck against the wall. And now it's grabbed by Byram. Thunderous hit. Oh, my.
Yeah, that one hurt me over here. That is an enormous hit. He closed the gap in a hurry.
Montreal's got the puck along the wall. Here they come on the attack. Moves it quickly over to Wilson. Montreal's got possession here in the offensive zone. Let's get the call.
Well, the first job's going to be to kill this penalty off, James, but maybe they take a chance down a goal to see if they can get a shorty.
Olofsson's won a big draw on their own end. No quarter given here as they battle for the loose puck along the boards. Back to the blue line. Letang's got the puck near the back end. Oh, what a stop by Bobrovsky. Letang's got the puck. And it's a quick pass to Patterson. Turns him away. There's back-to-back saves. They are really pouring on the pressure here. Referee signals penalty coming up here with a delayed call. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
Oh, he took way too long a run there on that hit. That's a boarding penalty.
McCann's won the draw here in the offensive zone. Turned that one aside. Montreal's got the puck. And that pass doesn't go. The 67's grab possession with the puck. Scooped up along the wall by Martinez. Feeds it over to Tuck. Takes a shot. Oh, misses.
You gotta like that he got into a position to shoot the puck. It's a dangerous scoring chance, but he's gotta get that on the net.
Past the midway mark in this period. Montreal's got a one-goal lead here. They're up 4-3. Batherson's won the draw inside the neutral zone. The 67's penalty has expired. They now go to work on the power play. And he makes the save on that play. Oh, wow, another great stop.
Quick reflexes. You make one, you make two stops before the puck is cleared away.
Sends it to the middle. Oh, and he fans on it. The 67's will play it from the defensive zone. Quick pass to McCann. Moves into the slot. Oh, tremendous athletic reflexes there with the toe stop. The 67's gain control of the puck. Nice save by the keeper to trap that puck to his chest. Puck sent down the ice. We'll get an icing. In the final moments of this period, Montreal's clinging to this 4-3 lead. Good job tangling up his opponent here. Stopped by the goaltender. Snaps one on net. Turns another aside.
And he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Mantha's got it along the wing. Quick shot. Sensational stop by Bobrovsky. The 67's get a hold of the puck along the boards. Sends the pass over. Moves it to Pasternak. Goes right to the crease. Stopped by the goaltender.
He's not going to face many more high danger chances than that, but he snares that attempt.
Here's a short pass to McCann. Handles the puck. Montreal's got control of it now from their own end. Pass broken up. Puck picked up by Mete. He says, let's get physical on that play. Montreal's got a hold of it against the wall. The 67's really need a goal here. They pulled the goalie and the extra attackers out. He got all of that one. And misses over the net.
The 67s are a frustrated group. You can feel it on their bench as they miss another chance.
Scores into the empty net. They just would not be denied.
No, tonight has been their night, and with the lead, they defend it well and put it away on this empty netter.
Montreal's added to their lead with the empty netter, and Ray, that's pretty much all she wrote, I would say.
Well, you grind away to get the lead through this much of the game, and they pull the goalie, they're going to pressure you. You put it away with a easy one into the empty net.
Sends it into the offensive zone. The 67's have pulled the goaltender here. They've got the extra attacker out on the ice in hopes of the goal. And the fans on their feet recognizing a solid victory here in front of them. Moves it over to Coleman. Close the book on this one here tonight.
Desperate times call for desperate measures. They pulled the goalie. It didn't pay off.
I mean, you're down to your last straw here, so you pull the goalie. You try and get something that can get you back in the game. It just didn't work. I mean, it makes the score look wrong, but this game was not last.
Well, listen to this place popping for the home team as they pay respect and homage to the home fans who pay their hard-earned money.
I think this is a cool tradition that started. I'm not even really sure if it's the last 10 years or so, but when I first saw it, I didn't think it would last. Now I'm like, it absolutely belongs. It's the right thing.
For Ray Ferraro, my name is James Cebulski. Thanks so much for joining us, everybody. Have a great night.
What's happening, everybody? Welcome back to EA Sports. I'm James Cebulski. It's a hot challenge, and it's ready to go down. Well, the moment of truth is almost upon us here. They are about to drop the puck. The Penguins start with possession as we are now underway. The Canadiens take possession of the neutral zone. Makes a move in front, scores!
Oh, that's a great move. He gets in so tight to the goaltender. He sells the shot, holds it onto his forehand, and then puts it away.
The Canadiens deliver perfectly late here in this first.
Grind away and wait for your chance. That's one way to play. They're able to do that. They get the opportunity, and it's in the net.
But sees the pass. Oh, he's going to get called on that slash. Quick whistle stops the play.
So late in the period, you're looking forward to the intermission. Now you got to scramble to get there.
Pittsburgh's won the faceoff. Hammers a shot. Nice pad save. There's another consecutive save. Feeds the puck across to Mantha. And look at this. We've got a 2-on-1. And he loses possession of the puck after trying to make one too many moves.
Don't mind the idea, but it doesn't work. Now you got a chase.
Grabbed along the boards by Heinen. And now he angles it across to Carter. Blocked in traffic. Mantha's lugging the puck. First period nearly in the books here. Puck grab by Duchesne. Backhand with intention. Made the save on the play.
I like the way he tracks the puck here. He's got to find it, and then he gets his body right in front of it. That's a good save.
Picked up along the boards by D'Angelo. Steps across the line and on the attack down the right side. A little dipsy doodle and he loses possession of the puck. Tries to get this man advantage going for their own end now. The Canadiens gain possession along the wall. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Puts it on net. Oh, he
just got enough of that to keep it out.
Puck scooped up by Carter. Through the neutral zone up along the wing. Read it perfectly and breaks up the play.
Well, we say that, James, because it looks so easy, but he's got to get rid of it quickly. He's trying to be perfect. He just misses the net wide.
Join us for our next team practice, which will be open to the public. Admission is simply by donation with all proceeds.
Period number two set to go here. Officials moments away from dropping the puck. The Penguins go right back to work on the man advantage for a few more seconds here as they win the draw. The Canadians will try to shave a few seconds off this penalty now. Look out, a two-on-one. Takes a shot. Fantastic save. Pittsburgh's gained possession along the boards.
Coleman's time is almost done.
The Penguins can't take advantage on the power. Scores! And consecutive goals here, and they're humming.
Now they're rolling downhill. They've got the momentum. They're the more aggressive team. They've got a chance to put this away really quickly. I don't know that she could get much closer to the net right in front of it. That's a quick release, and it's in the net past the goalie.
The Canadians get back to center ice. They have dominated this one here thus far.
Been by far the more sharp of the two teams, and a two-cop lead, that's where this should be.
And the score is reflective of... to this point. Quick feed to Crosby. And he gets a chunk of that to keep it out. Picked up along the wall by Stamkos. Love save made by Jari. Pittsburgh's got the puck in the defensive end. Moves inside! He scores!
Leak over into the next period, however.
The Penguins win the draw. Quick shot. Great save by Raja. Moves the puck over to Stamkos. Pittsburgh's got a hold of it along the wall. Lays the body into that play. Grabs the puck and moves on out here with this man advantage. The Penguins played along the boards. Sends it to the middle, and that doesn't connect. The Canadians gain possession of the defensive zone. And he takes the dish. And that goes off a body. Right up the gut into the offensive end. Final minute approaching here in this opening frame. And the puck departs the zone.
1 minute left.
The Canadians played along the wing. He almost lost it for a second. Scores! And look at that! The go-ahead goal comes shorthanded!
Man, that bench jumped up. What a bolt of energy for their team. Tied, but you're short of man. You just want to hang in the game here. But they come out of this somehow with the go-ahead goal.
The Canadians get a late goal here in the opening frame.
I like the way they played the last couple of minutes here, and they're rewarded with the first goal of the game.
Dished on over to Raquel. The Canadians will kill off a few extra seconds now. Here they come up along the wing. To his teammate! And that's broken up. The Penguins will play it in their own end. Poked away at center by Duchesne. Nice feed from the left side up the middle. Stays with it. Gets it over to Letang. Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck. The Canadiens carry it along the wall. Mantas moving the puck through his own zone. And now he moves it to Ekblad. Takes the puck behind his own cage. That'll do it for the opening frame. We've got lots more still in store, so don't even think about going anywhere for rail fun. Welcome back, everybody. James Cebulski with you. Period number two, the middle frame, ready to go. The Penguins take possession, and their man advantage unit won't have a lot of time to work with here. Disappointing power play effort as they serve up a shorthanded goal, but both teams now back to even strength.
Well, that doesn't go according to plan. The power play's done, and they've given up a shorty. Those are always deflating.
White Cloud's taking it from his own end. The Canadiens pick up steam and are on the attack. White Cloud stick handling in his own zone. Up along the wing. White Cloud's got the puck in his own zone. And the middle frame almost done. The Canadiens move the puck in the defensive zone. White Cloud's got it along the boards. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. White Cloud's got it in the defensive end. The Canadiens work it through center. White Cloud's lugging the puck. Gives it right back. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Oh, what a move! The Canadiens have it against the wall. Two on one. And he'll take a moment to regroup back at center. There it is. That's a wrap for period number two. Both teams will get a chance to get a little breather here, and we'll come back. Third period action next. Welcome back. James Cebulski ready to bring you all the play-by-play. Here we go. Put up or shut up for both teams here in this third period. We are underway. Well, we've got two periods under our belts to this point so far, Ray. How do you see things?
The Penguins are trailing in this game, and really sometimes the stats tell you the whole story. They have not had the puck very much, and as a result, they're not generating any offense.
White Cloud's got control of it now behind the cage. And he slides it quickly to Robertson. The Canadiens have it now. And takes a tour out of the offensive end to find some space at center. Stamkos plays it now. Nearing the final minute of the third. Can't find his man. Maintains control of the puck. And now it's over to Dumoulin. Quick stop by Ranta.
Traffic is set up well. I mean, it's difficult for the goalie to find the puck. But he battles through, finds it, and then is able to make a good save.
Looking to make something happen along the boards. Takes it out of the offensive zone and back to center. The Canadiens will play it in their own end. Into the offensive zone. Nurse has got it in the defensive end. Behind the net, looking for the transition game. The Penguins scoop it up along the boards. Moves it quickly over to Dumoulin. The Penguins really need a goal here. They pull the goalie and the extra attackers out. The Canadiens will play it from the defensive zone. Tosses it on to Nieminen. In on a breakaway with an empty net. Into the empty net. Great hustle to finally ice this one.
Well, you worked so hard defending a lead. Now if a puck bounces for you, it sure is nice to put it away.
And there it is, the final horn. Well, props to the man with the mask tonight as he gets it done in a big way.
Yeah, throwing a shutout up on the board is an awesome thing for a goaltender. You get lots of help in front of you, but you still have to stop the puck.
Look at these rosters. They're absolutely stacked. Let's see what's in store for this Hunt matchup. Great energy both inside and outside the arena tonight as we are just moments away now from puck drop. The Wolves take possession here on the opening draw and we are underway. Montreal's got the puck inside the defensive zone. C'est le dernier minute de la première période. Across the point. Drives to the sweet spot. And the puck skips away after that move.
Tries that last move. Maybe he should just shoot the puck or get it deep. Got a chase now.
Chicago's looking to break out. And he takes the pass. Montreal's got the puck along the boards. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. On the backhand, comes up with a monster save in front.
That flat-out reaction, James. That puck.
And in the dying seconds, they light the lamp and give them something positive to head into intermission with.
Well, that's going to be a big moment for them. They'll go into the locker room feeling good about this goal that's on the board now. See if you can springboard it into the next period.
The Canadians get one late. That's got to feel good here at this time of the period.
Oh, of course it does. You want to be in front anyway, but if you can take this lead into the intermission, now you've got something positive to build on.
Poked away in the neutral zone by Nurse. Quick shot! Oh, he gets a toe on that one to keep it out! Snaps one from the slot! Hey, a lot of people excited as this opening period comes to an end. One of the all-time great rock acts from the 80s getting set to play here for these fans. And we'll catch our breath. Back with more in a moment.
Fans, tonight our World Biggest Blitz is dropping $50 gift certificates. Keep your eyes to the sky for the next big prize.
Second period set to get underway. Second frame is underway as the puck is dropped. One period already in the books. Ray, how have you seen this thing?
Chicago's looking to overcome that slow start. They just didn't have it early. And by the time their legs started to come around, they were chasing the game. The second period gives them a new opportunity.
And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Poked away at center by Coleman. Puts the puck in play cross corner. Oh, we'll get some tired defenders as icing is the call. Late goings of this period. We got a 1-0 game to this point. Chicago's got it in the offensive zone.
Possession earned on the draw, James. We'll see if they can set something up.
Makes it look easy with the stop. Good fight for the puck along the boards. Montreal's got a hold of the puck. Quick pass to Robertson. Back to the point it goes. With possession along the wall. Chicago's got a hold of the puck in their own end, but the clock is winding down. Goalie plays it up. Montreal's got it against the boards. Lead pass ahead. Chicago's got it in their own zone. Shot! Turns aside the slap shot. Wow! And there's the horn, bringing an end to period number two. Still 20 minutes more of action in the third. Stick around. Welcome back to EA Sports. The final frame looms here as the officials set to drop the puck on period number three. Final frame is underway here. The play underway here in this third period, Ray Ferraro offers his own perspective on how things have gone out so far.
The Wolves have had a really bad night with the puck. Every time they have it, it seems like they turn the thing over, and as a result, they're chasing the game.
Chicago's emptied the net. The extra attacker's now out on the ice.
Another cushion onto the lead.
The Canadians make their way back to center ice, probably breathing a little easier here now, Ray.
Pretty much puts this to bed. The empty netter gives them a little bit more of a comfortable lead.
The Wolves win it. A chance! Stopped by the goaltender. He got a little piece of that one. The Wolves have pulled the goaltender here. They've got the extra attacker out on the ice in hopes of a goal.
Seemed like a good idea at the time, but you got no goalie. You better get the puck and hold on to it. If they don't, it ends up in their cage again.
Both teams gliding into position, and the official set to drop the puck. Handles the pass. Montreal's got the puck along the wall. Final seconds of this one, and the home fans certainly appreciate that they got their money's worth tonight. Said to me many years ago, show me a good coach, I'll show you a good goalie. There was a good one tonight.
Yeah, the team.
EA Sports, as we get set to drop the puck on a little hut. And we are about set to drop the puck tonight. And this one is officially underway with the puck dropping. Less than a minute to go here in the opening frame. From the blue line, they take control of it. Drives to the paint. Tremendous read as he pokes it away with the paddle. Steps into it. Oh, they do it again.
He's right on it. Two consecutive saves. Tough ones at that.
Assad's moving it up the ice. Moves it to Robertson. Assad's got it in their own zone. Shot! And he misses that one.
James, you're never going to get to call a goal here. I mean, that puck's got to be on the net. You don't get many good chances in a game. You can't fire one off target from that spot.
And a quick save on that one. Taken by Coleman. Back at the point, they set it up. In close! He scores! This is like the hockey equivalent of a buzzer beater, eh?
Yeah, it didn't look like there was going to be enough time. The puck's in the net, and now they feel really good about themselves going into the next period. Now, obviously, there's more than one way to beat a goalie. How about the old stumble, stay with it, don't fall over, and still find a way to beat him? Pretty nice goal.
Montreal's got the game's first goal here late in the first.
I've liked the way they've played most of this period, and now they're rewarded for all that fine work.
Well, fun start to this one as period number one comes to an end. We still got lots more still in store. Kids are coming out on the ice here to play the little mini prospects game, and we'll be back with more tonight. Teams are back on the ice, both squads gliding into position for the start of period number two. Here we go, middle frame now underway as the puck drops. Well, we've got over 20 minutes played thus far. Ray, how have you seen things?
Asat's puck work in the first period left a lot to be desired. They were sloppy with it, turned it over. They want to be a little smarter, a little more sure with the puck here in the second period.
Here's a breakaway! Stop with ease!
Whitecloud's able to get his balance back after he stumbled. He stayed in the play, and then he's able to get away a pretty good shot.
Montreal's got the puck against the boards.
Whitecloud's dangerous in the offensive zone. He's got it now, and he's already got the go-ahead goal. There's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Let's see what the officials are calling.
These late penalties in a period are really crucial. You want to kill this one off so you don't lose any momentum going into the break.
Look out! And that goes off someone in front and doesn't reach the net. That brings the period to an end. Ray and Carlin both off to get some poutine from the concessions. I'm going to grab some popcorn, and we're coming back with period number three in moments. Welcome back, everyone. He's Ray. I'm James. Third period action ready to go. Under a minute to go on the third. Horry's power play is still intact as this period is now underway, and they take possession. Rant is going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
Retrace gliding in for the faceoff as this penalty kill will continue. Assat's won the draw. Shot right in front! Too much traffic in the lane. Montreal's got the puck at the defensive end. Manages to hang on. And that plays offside. We got a faceoff coming up. Power play set to roll on as the setters get ready for the faceoff. Horry's won the draw. They take possession here in the open ice. And now he moves it quickly to Johansson. Horry's goalie is on the bench. The extra attacker has jumped into the play. Assat's got control of it now here in the offensive end. Takes the pass. They got a pair on a 2-on-1. Montreal's got him along the wall. Loves the puck into the corner of the offensive zone. And that pass goes awry. And that's all she wrote from this one tonight. Well, there he is. The man getting it done tonight was the one between the pipes.
Oh, yeah, I would.